I'm interested in the understanding the reproductive behavior in response to the environmental stress. What are the environmental stress? Stress can be the high temperature, desiccations, food limitation, pollutants, which can affect the organs. And temperature is one of the most important ecological factor, which decides the distribution of the ectothermic organisms, and it can also affect the fitness of the organs. Previous studies have reported that the temperature curve can affect the life state. They have looked at the evolution of the life state. The life state can be the longevity, fecundity, and so on. But temperature can also affect the reproductive behavior. So how we test this? Therefore, we have created the selection lines in our laboratory. So we have the five replicates of the BRB population. And from here we created the selection line, FSB, field shock line derived from the BRB, and field shock line control derived from the BRB population. On 12th day post egg collection, what we do, we transfer the plates from food vials to the empty glass vials, and then expose to the -5 degree temperature for 1 hour. And then allow them to recover 24 hours, and then allow them to interact in male and female. Then we give the fresh plate on 24 hour post cold shock, collect the next generation. And here in the control, we expose them to 25 degree temperature. It's a normal reading temperature. So this is a single event difference between the control and the selectors. So then we keep on doing this thing. Then we look at the 18 to 19 generation of the selections following mortality, fecundity, egg viability, male mating ability. What it does? Do cold shock affects the mortality? After 18 to 19 generation of the selections, we look at the plays. Again, we are doing the same things, whatever we do. On the 12th day, we transfer the play from food vials to the empty glass vials and then export. This protocol is the same for the year also. And then 24 hour post cold shock, we count the number of the day plays. So what we got? So we found that the mortality is not significantly different between the control and the selection. The treatment is the effects. Because it's not getting. Both shock, it means both sex, male and female got the shock. Neither shock, nobody got the shock. So then we think that it's not, selection is not responding. Because in the control, if you found that approximately 4% mortality happened. It means our selection is not acting on the mortality. So what can be the next? Then we look at the fecundity. Cold shock affects the fecundity. So again, it's the same thing. Here we give the female shock, and both male and female shock, and here none shock. So we give the same thing for the control as well as the selection. And then the 0 hour post, 0 to 6 hour, we give the plates to the laying eggs, and then we count the eggs, and 24 hour later we give them the another plates, then count them. So what is our result? So our result is here. There is no significant period effects at the 0 to 6 hour and 24 to 30 hours. So here it is suggesting that the fecundity is also not responding to the selections. Then what can be the interesting thing for the next? Then we look at the egg viability. Again, it's the same setup of the experiments, but here we give the plates, transfer the 100 number of eggs to the agar plate, and then allow them to put them in the incubator for 48 hours. Then we count the how many actually hatch, become a larvae. So that we found that here it's responding. See, soon after the shock, very low hatchability, egg viability means approximately 3 to 5% egg viability we found. But in neither shock, it's again close to the 90 or 95%. But here, after 24 hours post, they slowly recover, and this trait is significantly different between the control and here the female also significantly different. Even the female, we give the shock to the female only, then allow to access the fresh male without shock males, baseline males. So we found the interesting traits. Also, egg viability has selection is acting actually on the egg viability. So what are the things which is helping them to evolve the egg viability? It can be, are the selected females better at the protecting the sperm and x from the power shop, and then later on this. Then we look at the here on the y axis the number of the x, and this is not significantly different, but and here a variability is again very low, it means it's not responsive. Then what can be other thing? So we look at the mating behaviors. So same setup of the experiment, but what we give on the same cages, we observe the number of the mating pair in each cages every 30 minute intervals up to the 36 hour. So we found the interesting results in both shop as well as the in neither shop. The mating selected male made more selected lines had more number of the mating compared to the control. And interestingly, it's in the neither shop also. So it's suggesting that the mating is helping to the increase the availability in the selected lines. Then another thing, what can be the other things? Then we look at the male mating ability. So here it's a different experiment. We gave the shock to the only males. Okay. Then allow the males to the non-virgin females, access the non-virgin female. And female is the scarlet eye colors. After the 24 hour, we randomly pull out the 50 flies and each individual female we transfer to the bias and become a this progeny will come out. On 13 days, what we did? We count the flies related to the scarlet from each individual bias. And that individual bias is using for the scoring the disease. Here is the result. Proportion of the mating is even higher in the selected males. So male is the better at the they inducing the females to mate more. And here the red eye, the number of the progeny sired by the selected line is even higher. So, conclusion. Our results suggest that the reported behavior has evolved post-polishop. And the increased egg viability post-polishop is in the selected population is partly due to the mating. And the males from the selected population can recover faster and the mate more with the more number of the females and sire the greater portion of the progeny. I'm thankful to the European Society for Evolutionary Biology to give me a grant to present my work in Evolution 2014 conference. And I'm also thanks to the ICER Mohali. To provide me a platform to do a science. Yes, here is my supervisor, Dr. Indip sir. He is always helping how to come up with our own idea and test them to get a good results. And I am also thankful to my seniors and the junior MS kids who helping me during the experiment.
We have 7 minutes for questions. Come on.